In this how-to, we're going to take a look at using the cockpit map features of Flightplan in flight. Let's open a Flightplan, and we can just use the San Francisco to Hayward Flightplan we used in a previous how-to. And then we'll go into cockpit map. So when I switch to cockpit map, Flightplan takes the Google map and overlays it over Microsoft Flight Simulator. So I can navigate around in Microsoft Flight Simulator and my cockpit map remains on top. I can also minimize it or maximize it using the arrow. And then I can also set it to transparent to simulate a heads-up display. And let's load this same Flightplan in Flight Simulator. Once we've spawned in game, we can turn on GPS follow and it'll locate our aircraft and give us our bearing. And we should probably also set our default zoom level. So I have separate zoom and map type settings at the top of the screen, but I also have the options over the map itself. So I can temporarily zoom or pan in the map, and then when I turn GPS follow back on, it returns to the map zoom and the map type that I've asked for. And we can see in flight how that's helpful. So let's go ahead and take off and we'll look at some of these features in flight. Okay, so now that we're in flight on our way to the Golden Gate Bridge, you can see that Flightplan is following along with our aircraft as we fly. I have my default map zoom set at 13, which is, it's good for a small aircraft. We're doing 120 knots, so that, you know, if you're going much faster than that, you'll have to zoom further out. But at this zoom level, you'll see a lot of the landmarks and elevations and the names of the local places listed as you fly. So as I fly, I can use my map type and my zoom controls on the map without affecting my default. So let's say I want to take a look at the Sutro Tower. Well, when I drag the map, notice it turns off GPS follow. I can switch to satellite mode, and let's say I want to zoom in on it and look at it in satellite mode. Here's the actual Sutro Tower according to Google Maps, and here's the Sutro Tower in-game. And now that when I switch back to GPS follow mode, it'll restore my roadmap view at a map zoom level of 13. And there's the Sutro Tower. We can also see that currently, based on the waypoints that Flight Simulator is tracking, you can see our glass cockpit showing we left KSFO and we're headed to waypoint 1. Flightplan is indicating the same thing. San Francisco International with an elevation of 10 feet. Our next waypoint is the Golden Gate Bridge, and we've asked for an altitude of 1,000 feet. And you can see that it's tracking our distance right along with the glass cockpit. So we're supposed to be down at 1,000 feet. Okay, and as we pass over the Golden Gate Bridge, you'll notice that our current waypoint is reset to waypoint 1, which is the Golden Gate Bridge, and then it switches to our next waypoint, Alcatraz, in 2.5 miles. But let's say I want to skip Alcatraz and go just straight to my destination. What I can do is manually select Alcatraz as if that is my current waypoint, as if I've already passed it. It'll give me the detail, the caption will change, telling me this, you've selected Alcatraz and it, you're supposed to be at 1,000 feet. And now when I turn GPS follow mode back on, you'll notice that we've passed the Golden Gate Bridge, it's skipping Alcatraz, and it's telling me my next waypoint is Hayward Executive at 18.2 nautical miles. Even though the glass cockpit still says we're heading for waypoint 2 at 0.7 miles, which is Alcatraz. And notice what happened as we pass over Alcatraz. Flightplan recognizes, oh, wait a minute, you're right over the waypoint you selected. So we're going to go back to following automatically for you. So Flightplan allows you to manually set a waypoint and it will track from that waypoint to whatever the next waypoint is in the flight plan, in this case an airport. Or I can just double click it. Now I'm showing my distance to Hayward Executive, which is my next regular waypoint in the glass cockpit coming from the gate. Those are all the major features. There's more things that you can do with the cockpit map that we'll talk about in other videos. Thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this, please like and subscribe.